got any questions? I'm looking for hands. There's a lady over there in a dress. Yep, standing up. Yeah, your question?
Hi, I just wanted to know what kind of things, what makes a role appealing to you, and specifically what about these roles led you to choose the parts kind of thing.
So it's a question about what made these particular roles appealing and why you were drawn to them. Dan, would you like to say this?
Does this work? Well, for me, this is my third picture with Fabienne, I think she said, and you know, we had our last film premiere in Cannes, and we were at the after party pretty drunk. And I said, yes.
You were.
I said, okay, boy, what are we going to do next? I want to do something fun. Let's go to the USA. And she said, yeah, let's do the love story and find a really hot guy. No, you know, so that, and so the part obviously was amazing because how often do you get to see a female protagonist go on a journey like this? And you know, I trust Fabienne with my eyes closed, and she brings the best in me.
I was well aware that I was on a train entirely driven by women. I was just a passenger and I was very happy with that idea. You know, I mean, I read the script and I met Fabienne on the computer. And I just liked her right off the bat. And I don't know, it felt, sometimes you do things and, you know, you're acting in something and you're trying to make it real, and then sometimes you just sort of fit into something and it just feels real. And this one had the feeling that it was going to feel real. And I don't know. I mean, Diane can read the phone book and I just go, could you do it again? Yeah, I did a whole bunch of stuff.
No, I've spent a little bit of time there, but it definitely felt like the right place to shoot this movie. And, you know, we started out with our scenes, so we spent a lot of time in that house in the desert, and it definitely felt like we were we were cut off from the world, and we had this bubble where we could live our love story, and it kind of felt like once Norman was gone, the movie was over, yet we were still trying to.
And it was strange because we start the movie by the end, the shooting. So it was,
It was, you know, being in that house and just being with Norman every day, you know, you do fall in love. I cried over him dying, and it felt, we were really sad when it was over. And then, you know, I had to get married to the French guy again.
Thank you.
You know, I die and everything. But it's true, I die and everything. This question is how you prepare to die. But, you know, I have to tell you, I saw my dad die and my uncle die, and that sort of, that breathing was that breathing. And I remember, I'm still in Georgia right now, but when I saw that death scene, I looked so much like my dad, right there. And I had it turned off. But I don't know, it's, you know, I don't know, something about, you know, Diane's hand here and this very intimate room, and I don't know, I saw both of them, they were twins as well. So I saw that happen, and it's just not there. But I don't know how you prepare that to die. They're all different, you know, not the same, but
okay, anybody got any questions? I can't really see in the balcony, but has anyone got any there? Anyone want to yell one out from the balcony?